Okay, everyone, we're getting started here. I want to welcome you all to the 73rd annual Jamestown Fair Parade. And I'm not sure they've had 73 parades, but we've had 73 fairs. I know we've had at least 46 parades because this is the 46th time that I've been here working. So welcome, everyone. We have our color guard coming today. We'd like everyone to please rise as they approach. Gentlemen, to remove your hats, please. Jamestown Post 5424, our VFW color guard and honor guard. Good. Make sure we give them a hand. Always want to thank our veterans for what they do. That's why we're here today. Thanks to all our veterans. Following the VFW today is the Jamestown Girl Scouts. Representing the Daisy, Brownie, Junior Cadet, Senior, and Ambassador troops, the Girl Scouts currently have over 50 girls in grades kindergarten through 12th. The five troops participate in several community service projects, earning their badges and going on trips, having fun, their leadership skills, and they're always looking for new members. Join in the fun. Next up, the 125 Honda. It's a local story. It was owned and purchased by Roger McElhaney in 1968, and then Roger tragically lost his life on July 16th of 1969 while serving in Vietnam. And before he did, he rode that 125 all the way to Florida, and now it's driven this year by his great nephew, Dylan Babcock. The Speedex from Ravenna, Ohio, the company closed in 2000. It was a made in America tractor. That's a Model 1040. It was made in 1973. That's the 150th Pennsylvania Volunteer Infantry, the Pennsylvania Bucktails. They're a family-based organization from communities around western Pennsylvania, including some here in Jamestown. They're involved in many community activities, and living history events, school talks, reenactments, and they travel to places like Gettysburg, Antietam, Bull Run, and Cedar Creek. They're actually now restoring the Civil War Monument in Diamond Park in Meadville, PA. And their program is called Muster in the Park. So I'm sure they're looking for anybody that can make donations or help with that. They've also gone and repaired numerous Civil War headstones at the various cemeteries in our area. And if you're interested in joining the Bucktails, just contact any of their members. Get yourself a uniform and a musket, and away you go. Now we know where they're going to do for us again. Yeah! Doesn't get any better than that. Give him a hand.
Freeze it! Four!
Next up today is our Jamestown Parade Ambassador, Dave Velawson from Jamestown, PA. Any of you know Dave and all the things that he's involved with and all the great work that he does to help bring this to us every year. Dave's a good neighbor, friend, Lion, community member. Thanks for everything, Dave. And our mayor, Esther McClyman's today. Beautiful day for that convertible. Just so you know, your mayor ordered the weather today, so it's not going to rain till after the parade's over.
Nice day, huh?
Next up are your Jamestown Fair officials, your President Danny Dickey, Vice President Ann Pearson, Secretary Charlene Kink, Treasurer Jean Keene, Assistant Secretary Corinne Livingston, Assistant Secretary Nadine Hout, Assistant Treasurer Connie Durst, and Liaison Dave Lawson. These are the people that make the fair put on for you. Let's give them a hand. Without their work every year, we wouldn't have our parade here today. Next up, the Jamestown Fair Queen and her court, Mackenzie Brinzier, Erica Johnston, Sydney Bruce, Kirsty Berwick, Megan Feldhaus, Alyssa McClymans. Our flower girl today is Alyssa Harmon, and the crown bearer is Logan Cadman. And right behind the Fair Queen today is Jamestown High School Muskies Marching Band, under the direction of Mr. James Dutko. They're looking great this year. They're the 2013 Grand Champions of the Thrills Concert Band Competition in Hersey, PA, and I know they're still competing in many competitions throughout the area. Yeah, give him a hand. Following the Muskies band today is the Jamestown School District Teachers and the Jamestown Education Association. The Jamestown teachers are proud to be part of the great tradition of the Jamestown Fair Parade. They're grateful for the opportunity to educate the children of Jamestown, and they look forward to another successful school year. If anybody's paying attention, you read the paper, you know what Jamestown School District has been awarded with and recognized for in the past decade or so. So they must be doing some good things. We should all be proud of them. Following the teachers today, we have the Jamestown Pharmacy, your local family pharmacy, with free delivery to your home or office, free children's vitamins, free care-fill medication packaging to sort your medications for you, and their free care sync medication synchronization service. It's easy to keep your dollars in the local economy by going to the Jamestown Pharmacy and let them take care of you. You'll be pleasantly surprised with the area's lowest prescription prices and the best service available. They now have locations in Greenville, Linesville, Andover, Transfer, and Mercer. The Wahlberg Family Pharmacies are proud to be in your neighborhood and certainly right here at Jamestown. Following the Jamestown Pharmacy today is another Jamestown organization that we should all be very proud of and make sure that we give them a hand as they go by is your Jamestown Area Volunteer Fire Department and Rescue Squad. Today with Engine 89, 2006 Spartan. Number two is their Freightliner is a 97. Their Rescue Freightliner is a 95. Their International Road Rescue Water Unit and their Dodge Brush Truck, which is brand new. And of course, your Jamestown Volunteer Fire Department Ambulance Service. When they send you a donation card in the mail, there's a reason for that. They're doing this as volunteers. This only exists if we help, and money is help. So please, think about a donation to your Jamestown Volunteer Fire Department. Join the ambulance service. Buy their tickets when they're selling raffle tickets. Let's go. You guys can give them a hand. You will if they come to your door. If you're gonna throw candy, throw Tootsie Rolls. Any of those trucks have a siren on them? Jim. Following the Jamestown Volunteer Fire Department today are the Spinet Twirling Club from Conneaut Lake area, directed by B.J. Murray. Girls 4 years and up, and boys, I believe. Membership and lessons are free. Now, you can't beat that. If you're looking for something for your youngster to do, B.J. is offering something for kids to get together, have some fun, learn how to twirl, go to the parades, and it's all for free. Can't beat that. BJ and the Spinettes have been doing this for parades for 48 years. It's hard to believe. They still look like they're having fun. Following the Spinettes today, we have Robbie Burns driving a 1936 Massey Harris Pacemaster. Tractor's owned by Stan Liska. And Stan with Checky and Robbie Burns spent last winter restoring this tractor. So this is a new restoration. They did a nice job on it. What a great winter project. Well, thank them for bringing it out today. Robbie looks like he knows what he's doing out there. Next up today, our Harvest Baptist Church. Grow in grace and in knowledge of our Lord and Savior. There's excitement at the Harvest Baptist Church, and growth is seen week to week in the lives of men, women, boys, and girls. God's word has been given to us so that we can be born again and then grow spiritually from babies in Christ to maturity. Come join us this week and see how we have good things growing at the Harvest Baptist Church, located at 516 East Jamestown Road between Jamestown and Greenville. They look like they're having fun. That's a nice looking float. Next we have the Stray Haven Animal Shelter in Greenville, Pennsylvania. It's a no-kill shelter caring for stray cats and dogs since 1960. Located at 94 Donation Road in Greenville, volunteers are always welcome. And today we have with us Sheldon, Spooky, and Buck. And I'm assuming that they're all available. Rescue, raise, and love them. Take one home. Next, we have the 2016 Miss Crawford County Fair Queen alternate, Caitlin Knapp. And Caitlin's a 2015 graduate of Crawford Junior Senior High School. In the senior class float, the senior class of 2017. Following the senior class float today under the direction of Mr. Glenn Cameron, the Conneaut Area Eagle Marching Band.
What do you guys want to call at the start line? Do you have one? Do you have a start line?
Okay. The band is supported by the Conneaut Area Friends of Music. They got their eagle out there in the front. I'll bet that's a warm outfit. Thank you. Give them a hand. They sound great today. Following the Conneaut Area Eagle Marching Band today are your Mercer County Republican Party representatives. We all know this is a voting season and it's time to think about what's going on, pay a little bit of attention, and make sure you get out and vote. The Mercer County Republicans this year, our Congressman Mike Kelly, State Senator Michelle Brooks, State Representative Park Whitling, State Representative Ted Nesbitt, Mercer County Commissioner Scott Boyd, Mercer County Commissioner Matt McConnell, and Mercer County Treasurer Ginny Steese Richardson. Following your Mercer County Republicans today is a 1953 Farm All H, driven by Jonas Rhea from Jamestown. A 53 Farm All Super M, driven by Sean McGuigan from Jamestown. Following the Super M today is a John Deere 520 with Justin Kantz from Connie Lake, PA.
Hey, how are you?
Next up, the junior class float from the class of 2018. Fireworks. The junior class float has good things growing and blowing up. Yeah, more pyrotechnics. Where's the flames? Behind the junior class float today is Miss Shakelyville 2016, Sadie Mink. And Sadie's in a 2012 Camaro provided by Gordon's Auto Service today. Couldn't be a better day to be in a convertible. And behind Miss Shakelyville is Junior Miss Shakelyville. Or Little Miss Shakelyville. Riley Payne and Megan Hahn. And then Chipola Farms. Right here local. Established in 2008. First farmer stand was in Greenville. They now have four stands in PA and Ohio. Their newest location is at Lago Winery. Family of veterans supporting all past, present, and future veterans. And it says here, hey Mary, we saved a spot for you. So Mary, if you're out there, they've got your spot ready for you. Behind Chipola's today, Reynolds High School Marching Band. This year's field show is themed around colors. Today you're going to hear a portion of that show. Their theme this year is colors. Today we're going to hear Painted Black. Give them a hand, they're working hard out there. They came ready to win today. Following the Reynolds High School Marching Band is a one-of-a-kind 1929 mobile outhouse, driven by our one and only Tom Patton. Only Tom would have a mobile outhouse he could take with him anywhere he goes. And he needs it. Following Tom today is a 1977 Pontiac Trans Am, driven by Michael Jurenovich from Jamestown. Got the puppy along for a ride. Next up, the Jamestown Lions Club. It's the 100th anniversary for Lions Internationals this year. There are over 1,300,000 Lions in the world in 200 countries. Today we have on our float the District Governor Bernadette Holzer and her partner, another Lion, Robert. And on the float also today are two youngest members, Kyle Miller and Evan Galt. Jamestown Lions last year raised and distributed over $71,000 in your local community. And just so you know, approximately $60,000 of that stayed right here in Jamestown. The other part of that money goes for things that you're all aware of, like Leader Dog School, Lions Puppy Program, Hearing and Diabetes Research and Awareness, Blind Bowlers Association, Pennsylvania School for the Blind, and other things like Pennsylvania Beacon Lodge Camp for the Blind. Next up, Butch Butterball of Williamsfield, Ohio, on his Model D John Deere, produced from 1923 to 1953, the longest production run of all two-cylinder John Deere tractors. The first Model D was on steel, and Butch has this one modified so he can drive it on the road. It was the first tractor to have the name John Deere on it. Following Butch is Jim Butterball in a 1936 BR. Doesn't say what year it is. And the Westford Flower Club, organized in 1932. Their meetings are held March through December, the first Thursday of the month at the Towshenango Township Building. 84 years of flowers and friendship. New members are always welcome. And the freshman class float, the class of 2020. We have good things growing as well. And next up, your Democratic Committee for 2016, again. Check out who's running, check out the issues, make up your mind, and get out to vote. Following the Democrats today is St. Paul's Caring Community from Greenville, PA. They're always having a great time at St. Paul's. And if you know someone that's at St. Paul's and needs a visit, now's a good time to think about that and commit yourself. Take a neighbor, go visit some friends. Now we have the Westford Flower Club. We're a little out of order here. They always put together a really nice float for us. The ladies put a lot of work into that. They enjoy their flower club. And like I said, new members are always welcome. Nothing much lasts for 84 years, but they've been around that long. Next up is a Ferguson TO35 Deluxe. Chad Ferguson from Jamestown, PA. And following that Ferguson today is the freshman class float. And have to apologize to the judges. We got some things out of order here. Following the class float from the freshmen is the 215 restaurant in Jamestown, PA. We've got good things growing at 215. Longer hours, expanded menu, live entertainment, and nightly specials Wednesday through Saturday. Stop by their table at the gym up at the fair, and they're going to give you a special coupon code for today. So there's some special that if you go up and see them at the fair, they're going to give you a code. Next up is a 1993 GMC truck with Bill Kidwell from Jamestown, PA. And following that is the Ashtabula County Antique Engine Club. The club was organized 35 years ago. They're located 4 miles west of Williamsfield on Route 322. The Ashtabula County Antique Engine Club is a nonprofit organization with the purpose of collecting, preserving, restoring, and exhibiting engines, vehicles, machinery, and equipment of any historical value. Their three-day event is the first weekend in July every year. They've got an engine on that trailer that I've got three just like sitting at home. Next up, West Salem Volunteer Fire Department Rescue 73, 2000 Pierce. Today with Chief Tom Hunt and Junior Chief Cody Hunt. Cody's having fun. Following West Salem today is the Little Miss Country Beauty Pageant contestants for the Jamestown Country Beauty Pageant Queens of 2016. We have Miss Pumpkin Patch, Sophia Fornell, Miss Sugar and Spice, Riley Good, Miss Fair Daisy, Natalie Miles, Miss Country Cowgirl, Fallen Lance, Miss Farmer Jane, Emily Enterline, Miss Quilted Memory, Trinity Umland, and Miss Country Beauty, Isabel Galt. There's all your 2016 Jamestown Country Beauty Pageant Queens. Next up, the Pyme Tooming Rentals and Information Center in Jamestown. Their new kayak and inner tube canal rental business opened Memorial Day this year at the old hotspot. They're gearing up for the Big Scare float throughout October and has pumpkin patch, corn stalks, mums, and straw pumpkins for $5 each. They're also announcing a New Year's Eve family celebration of sled riding at the state park, fireworks, and a heated shuttle. Snowman contests benefits the establishment of the Rails and Trails Trailblazer Club. So they're raising money for a good cause. Next up, 1942 Farmall H. Actually, that's the MTA, Super MTA, 1954. And then a 1953 Farmall Super M. And then we have the 1942 Farmall H. Those are all owned by Dick Saramuga of Jamestown, PA. And following the tractors today, the Mark Twain Manor, representing the Manor moments. Miss Poise and Miss Grace. These lovely young ladies hope not only to grow into their titles, would like to encourage you to come and see what's growing at the Manor. From the haunted lantern tours in the fall to the enchanting Christmas tree tours in December. We look forward to seeing you come out and support the historical building, a part of the Jamestown community since 1855, and we hope to have it remain for many years to come. Next up, the Log Cabin Unity Grange. Founded in February of this year, the Log Cabin Unity Grange is where we promote family and community. It looks like they promote log building. They put a lot of work into that. Following the Log Cabin Unity Grange today is a 1941 Farmall H, driven by Shelley Mines of Kinsman, Ohio. That tractor was bought new in June of 1941. It's been in the same family since that. It's now a third generation family owned tractor. That's just amazing. It's like a good wife. If you get one, you better hang on to her. Maybe not three generations, but. Next up, a 1955 McCormick Farmall 400, driven today by Randy Mines of Kinsman, Ohio, that has an independent PTO and torque amplifier on it. And finally, a 1946 Farmall, driven by Jacob Nicholas from Evans City, PA. That tractor was restored by Brian, Adam, and Jacob Nicholas. It's a 46, and they use it to cut grass and do yard work. And it took them many hours to restore it. They look proud of it. Next up, Miss Erie County, Samantha Maddox. I think Samantha's arm's gonna get tired. You better switch hands. Following Miss Erie County today is the Fallowfield Volunteer Fire Department. Following the Fallowfield Volunteer Fire Department today is Calvin's Cuts and Curls. Established in 1999, they formerly started in Greenville, but now they're down here at the Jamestown where the video shelf used to be. Several services: hair cutting, nails, pedicures, tanning beds, They're planning a grand opening kickoff this fall for the weekend of September 19th. So watch for any specials they're going to have. And some giveaways. Calvin's Cuts and Curls. Next up, a 1966 Ford 80 lawn tractor driven by Andrew Livingston. It even has a horn on it. Following the 1966 lawn tractor today is a 1960 John Deere 430. And that's driven by Joe Broner. It's a 430 utility, and mostly that tractor is in original condition. They're pretty rare. Next up, the Pymatuming 4-H Club. Plant your kids in 4-H and watch them grow. The Pymatuming 4-H is accepting new members. You don't have to have a farm animal to be in 4-H. Our members do cooking projects, wood carving, and sewing. We also have dairy cows, goats, and rabbits. Find out more, check out the 4-H Club at the county, Crawford County Extension Office. Next up, Dobson American Garage Door. Been in the garage door business 20 years. They do garage doors, windows, and entrance doors. 24-hour day, 7-day service. And they offer a discount to our military veterans. So make the right call to a Dobson American Garage Door. Oh, and that's Karen Flaw, your parade chairman. Following Karen today is a 19... Actually, don't have any idea who that is, but it's an old Chevy, I can tell you that. And then Lori Fedekick with their outreach, part of a small nonprofit organization, and their goal is to help people in need. This year they hope to achieve help to feed 5 families for Christmas. Pikachu is out there to help them. And then a 1938 Chevy truck making a little noise there, Gary. Got the grandkids in the back. Take her easy. Then the Greenville Gymnastics Academy and Cheer Group. Then a Chevy truck with a Corvette LT1 engine in it. Custom paint redone about 15 years ago, owned by Jim Motes of Greenville, PA. And a single jogger. The race ended hours ago. She still thinks she's winning. Next up, a GMC, blue and gold. And following the GMC pickup truck today is the Hempfield Fire Rescue. And now the horses. First up, Molly Holbrook from Conneaut Lake with her pony. She's put a lot of work into that pony today. I'm not sure if it's a skeleton or a zebra, maybe a little bit of both. But that deserves some kind of special prize. I've never seen a decorated horse painted like a skeleton. Following Molly's today, is a first time shower here at the fair. This is your grand champion at the fair this year, a Halfigan gelding. I think it's Augustus. They ride better than they write. Next up, Chauncey, driven by Linda Wilburn, a wannabe farm in Sandy Lake, PA. Chance is a second place winner. She pulls in a team hitch. Visit Chance at the miniature horse barn. I think you can visit Mickey there too.
Ha ha! There's Mickey.
Next up is Harley, a 9-year-old gelding registered miniature horse. Harley's been a champion gelding at fairs for many years, and he's currently here at the Jamestown Fair. So go up and see Harley at the fair with Lady Liberty. Wow, Harley, you're really looking patriotic out there today, buddy. Having more fun than any horse should. Next up, Elizabeth is 10 years old. She's in the fifth grade. She lives with her parents at Almet Acres. She raises many animals. And her favorite are the miniature horses, Sam and her dogs, Roxy and Luna. She has a vegetable garden and a pumpkin patch. And this summer, she's a member of Make, Bake, and Create 4-H Club. I like these get-ups. Next, Tammy Graham of Carlton, PA, and her miniature horse. And Norman, he's a miniature donkey from Carlton, PA, owned by Kathy Graham. Hi, Norman. Norm. Next up is 12-year-old Hannah Kunkel, leading Faith. She's 2 years old and a registered miniature horse. And Faith is painted in the 60s style today. Following Faith is Wildflowers, Julia Carson and her Britain Walking Tilly. Taylor Greg Walking Ginger. Tilly won first place in the Light Horse Senior for Halter and Reserve Grand Champion Mare. Ginger won second place in Light Horse Senior for Halter. So there's a couple of your fair champions right there. Give them a hand. And last, Ann Pearson, our fair vice president, who's always the end of the parade and makes sure her horse people get back to the barn safely and we all walk carefully. Thanks, everybody. See you next year for the 74th annual Jamestown Parade. Same bat time, same bat channel.
Seven categories, and I got four fire towers. You know that.